So we'll see now substitution method in simultaneous linear equations. Okay, using this method how we can solve the solutions of simultaneous linear equations, right? For example, suppose we are given two linear equations in x and y. Okay, with the examples, let me show you. For example, solve two linear equations, so simultaneous linear equations. Solve 3x minus y is equals to 23, this one equation, and 4x plus 3y, okay, 4x plus 3y is equals to 48, this is second equation. So we need to solve. So whenever you are given two linear equations in x and y, first you should express y in terms of x from any one of the equation. So from these two equations, we should express y value in terms of x. Okay, let me take equation 1. So which is small, simple terms, you can take it easy. Now, from equation 1. So I am going to solve this. From equation 1, 3x minus y is equals to 23, right? From this, we need to express the letter y. Okay, this term, solution of this y in terms of x. So only y is equals to, remaining all should take other side. That means minus y should be take left side. So only y letter should be one side, remaining terms must be other side. Then y I am taking right and 23 taking left side. Then I will change, minus y is plus y. All the 3x, this is minus 23, right? Now y is equals to 3x minus 23. Okay, this is the first step we need to do, express y in terms of x. Now this y value should substitute in equation 2, other equation. So one equation you take and find y value, this y value should be substitute this y value in the other equation to obtain a linear equation x. Now y value I am substituting in equation 2. Then from second, that is 4x plus 3y. Now 4x plus 3y is equals to 48, right? After getting value of this y, you should substitute there. That is 4x plus 3 in the place of y. That whatever we simplified now from first equation, substitute this. That is 3x minus 23 is equals to 48. That means total equation we are converting in terms of x. Now this will simplify to obtain the value of x now. Okay, 4x plus 3 into 3 is 9x minus 3 into 23. Okay, 69. Right, that is equals to 48. 4x plus 9x is 13x minus 69 is equals to 48. Then 13x is 48 plus 69. Take the constants on side. Then 13x is 48 plus 69. Okay, that is 117. Then from this, x is equals to 117 by 13. Okay, 13 nines are 117. 13 nines are 13 nines. So cancel. So x is equals to 9 now. Once you get x value, you will get by substituting x value in equation either is in this y. Okay, let me take it as equation 3. First step is take one of the equation and find the value of y. Take the other terms one side. This y value substitute in equation 2. Okay. Then after getting x value, x is equal to 9, substitute in this equation 3. So y is equal to 3x minus 23. So we got x value is 9, right? Yeah, x is equal to 9. Therefore substitute x is equal to 9 in equation 3. That implies y is equals to 3x. So 3 into 9 minus 23. So it's 27 minus 23. That is 4. Now y is equals to 4. X is equals to 9 and y is equals to 4 we got. These two are the solutions. Therefore, x is equals to 9 and y is equals to 4. This both, hence these two are the solutions of the given equations. So we can do checking also, it's right or wrong. The two equations, if you substitute in this equation 1 and 2, we'll get it. So just to see the checking also, this is not necessarily in the problem, just for our confirmation whether our solution is right or wrong. Just you can do checking to correct or not. So that is 3x. So x value is 9 minus y value is 4 is equals to 23. So 27 minus 4. 27 minus 4 is 23 is equals to 23. Yes. LHS is equal to RHS. Same solution you can check in equation 2 also. Okay, if we substitute 4x plus, okay, here 4x plus 3y is equal to 48. So 4 into x is 9 plus 3 into y is 4. Okay, 36 plus 12. That is 48, right? This is also 48. LHS is equal to RHS. This you can do only for confirmation, for checking. This way we can simplify the find the solutions. Just only substituting. So after the equation is given, take one equation, find the value of y. That y value substitute in equation 2. We'll get x value. After getting x value, you substitute in equation 3. Means whatever you got from first, then you get the value of y also. Okay, this is one of the method to find the solution. So more problems also, I'll explain continuation. First of all, we'll see the one more method. That is elimination method. After seeing these two methods, I'll explain you similar problems more.